Welcome back to Farming Simulator 2017 with the Rude Man. We are back in Ponderosa, and in the last episode, we were finishing up on canola, so I think we've got a field left to do there. We'll take a look at that. In the meantime, let's talk about the animals, because we had done that. We had just fed everything. Now, if you notice over here, there's a discrepancy, because we just fed everything, but right after we did it, I bought a bunch of cattle. So that took what they were full up on everything down to about halfway, because I doubled my my amount of cows. So I need to continue on with that. But let's go up and finish the harvest. We were doing canola, and I think I've got, well, let's put this stuff away. I think that I have one field that's not quite done, or two. Let me just go take a look. But we'll finish that up, and then we're going to start seeding today. We're going to start seeding some whatever, sunflower seeds, I think is what I talked about. All right, so that's done. This guy's, we're going to take this guy because I think, let's look at the field issue. All right, let's look at plowing. Yes, okay, so we're going to finish this little area right here that didn't get quite done. There's a couple patches there to do. But I forgot all about owning field 26. I completely forgot about it. We bought this field, we harvested it, then I did all this harvest and forgot all about that field. We did not reharvest it, but it needs to be plowed. So let's go ahead and plow everything and finish the harvest that we were working on. And I tell you what, let's move this guy down. I think he's pretty much done. Let's lower the wheels on the header, and we're going to lower the header and detach from it. Let's get our other combine, who was just finishing this field up, and let's do that. Going to hire somebody to help us here, and then we'll check to see who we got. All right, Wyrie. Got Wyrie working on the farm today. And he's not going to get this because this field is kind of weird shaped here. So I'll wait until Wyrie's done. If you're interested in being a helper on my farm like Wyrie is, take a look at the patron page. It'll tell you all about it. And you can become a patron and you can work with me on the farm. You can get all my mods. And it starts out as little as a dollar. He's actually going to try to get that. That surprises me. Can you do it? Like, by golly, he's going to try. Well, good job. Okay, let's get this stuff picked up and sell some of this. I'm thinking about putting the a compost machine like this on every farm. So that means that, let's see, where are we at with this guy? Let's get this guy up here and pick that up, and then I'm going to put him down taking the straw out of the hayloft. Because I was thinking of emptying the hayloft out, because I don't think I have a need in it right now. And if I do, I can always repurchase it. But I'm thinking about getting rid of the hayloft, and that's going to give me room on the main farm that I can put a compost machine in there. We've got so much straw to handle, and if I can make money off it by making compost, why not? So I'm thinking about putting one on every farm and leaving the one right there too. Let's put this guy away. Oh, come on. JCB's on sale. Well, I can't afford one. I only have $1,000 here. That's why I need to sell some compost. And I've yet to pick up eggs. I should probably do that, too. I mean, every little bit helps. give me a little bit of gas money. Not much. Gas pretty expensive on this farm. All right, I'm going to pull this in and do the same thing I did with the other one. We're just going to drop it like it's hot. All right, here we go. Lower that and drop it. Okay, let's get this guy taken care of. And then I got to get that. I got so much to do. There's always so much to do. So much to do and so little time. Whoa, 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 whoa. All right, you come out of there. Come on out. You can go back to picking up the mixed rations. Now I'm gonna have to pay attention to the milk and the poo situation now because I got a lot more animals. All right, get this thing going and that's whoa. All right, now, take this guy down, over, not down, but over. Now, see what I mean? If I don't have the hay loft, I can probably put another compost maker in here. Or more mixing stations, one of the two. But I've got so much straw that I might as well make compost out of it and sell it for good money. All right, let's get some more straw out of this. Let's go get this fella. We need to catch up on some things that the map was showing us we had missing here. Like that little area right there. Let's do that. There's some pretty good hills on that right behind me there that I just drove over. Some pretty good lumpy oatmeal. All right, so let's clean this up just a little bit. And here. And then let's see, which field was it that had a little bit of an issue? I think it was, yeah, it was 23 and the end of 22. There's a couple of little places. I wouldn't mess with this except for I only plow every three harvests. So I want to make sure that every little stitch gets done so that I don't have to look at those ugly red things in between the next two harvests, if that makes any sense. Also, see that gold nugget? If you remember, I ran around and found all the gold nuggets. And then I had to reset the game. So the gold nuggets are still out there. So technically, I've got another $1 million out there that I can gather. Should do that, really. If for no other reason to clear up all the stupid gold nuggets that are laying around all over the place. Why not, eh? Not sound like I'm Canadian. I'm ootin' a boot. Why not, eh? Take off, you hosers. People have asked me to look at the Aberdeen map. I have downloaded it, but I haven't looked at it yet. I'll try to take a look at that today or tomorrow. I'm pretty sure it's not going to be a map I like. In the description, they're saying that there's hedges and bushes all around everywhere and that they all have collision on them. I hate that. All right, let's see. Right here, for some reason, this end has some issues with the plow. So let's just kind of do this end right here. The field has already been plowed. I don't really need to plow it. I'm just cleaning up these little red marks here. There's a sizable right here in the corner, a sizable one. Right there. All right. Let's get on with life. Let's not go that way. I love this tractor. I don't particularly like the tractors like this, the articulated tractors. I don't particularly like them, but I like the way this one sounds. I like the way it drives, and I like the fact that it looks like it's big and powerful enough to handle a plow the size of this. And I just like it. I just do. I like to drive it. It's fun to drive. So we're heading up to what we're calling farm number two. It's not much of a farm. Doesn't have many buildings or anything. Got a silo there. But it's got a spot where you can put buildings and make it into a farm, if you will. So, but I completely forgot. That's a sizable field. I could have had another bunch of canola had I remembered that I owned this field and seeded it last harvest. I did not. I got to remember to do that. And I want to buy this field too, but of course, it's a spendy field, so it's going to take me a little bit of work. Okay, now this field here is weird because it's got actually three pieces to it. If you start working on this corner here, it doesn't work out. They stop in the middle of the field. I don't know why you'd want to start in this corner, but the same thing. So what I found is if you start working in this upper corner here. Now see, here's part of the field, then it's got an L shape to it. That's what I mean, it's kind of a three-piece field. And then that's not over yet either, because then there's another little L shape right here that gives it the third piece. Now even though it's a very small piece, it's still enough to fool the workers. So I found if you start in this corner over here, now, depending on the width of the piece of equipment, they generally are able to figure their way out from this corner to that corner way over there without too much trouble. We're going to try it, but I think I can do it. So if you want to work this field, always start in this corner. It's your best bet. So let's hire somebody and see who we've got working here. Brian Wheeler's working here today. Okay, Brian, do us proud, buddy. Let me just go around and see what else I've got going here. Let me get this guy going. And then we'll go check the mixed rations. Let's check that. All right, looks like we got all the mixed rations out of here. No, we don't. What's going on here? It's still making some. Okay, so then we need to refill this now that we've got it fairly empty. Uh-oh, trouble. All right, trailer, get out of the way. I got to remember to come and continue feeding the animals because the cows need a little bit more tender love and care since we have more cows now. And we're coming down on this. Okay, so let's see how he's doing. Oh, he just made two passes. That's a big field. All right, let's get this guy out. We got to do some seeding. I'm going to do... Whoop! I keep forgetting that I'm unhooking equipment to keep it off of the inspector mod. All right, let's just bring this guy out in here. And we'll get our truck. And I think that tractor needs some fuel. So we'll do a little bit of everything here. Seed, fertilizer, and fuel. Pull up, give him some fuel. That's going to take a while, so let's let that go. In the meantime, let's get these guys... Well, let me see if I can get under that from this angle. Is there anything going in it? No. Alright, let's back him up. Get a better angle at it. There we go. All right, we'll let him fill. We'll let him full. What's going on here? Oh, that's it. One more straw. Cool. All right. I wonder if there's grass left in there. Did I leave that tractor in there? I sure did. I'm bad at that. I'm terrible at that. Leaving this guy laying around. I'm going to pull him over here out of the way for a minute. And then we'll empty this guy. And then let's go see what we've got left in that hayloft and see if we've got it empty yet. I think there might be some grass left in it. Not sure. Might be some odds and ends in here. We'll take a look. Whoa, I hit the building. Not good. Now see, even if I need to bring it back, it's not that expensive. It's only $40,000 to replace it. Yeah, there's grass left in it. Anything else? All right, nothing else, just grass. All right, let's get that and mosey around. I need to get that. This guy's full. Whoa, not that guy. This guy. Okay, let's pull this guy underneath. Get him full. And what else we got going here? All right, let's see. He's got his fuel. Let's pull this guy around and get the other side. All right. All right, he's full. So let's move him out to a field. I think I'm going to go down below and start because these all need to be plowed. So we're going to start with the fields that are already plowed. So we can get pig pen down to 23, I think it is. We're not going to do rape. We're going to do sunflower seeds. I think. Let's double check. See what I need. Whoop, there we were. Yeah, sunflower seeds. We have some soybeans. We've got canola, we've got barley, we got wheat, we got corn and potatoes. So let's grab some sunflower seeds and we'll say we're full up, which we're not, but at least we'll have a little bit of everything. Okay, right about here. And let's get started. Let's see what we've got working down here. Daryl's working. All right, let's just run through the gamut here. See what we've got. There's the grass. Let's move the grass around. There's just always, always so much work to do on the old farm. Keeps us hopping, I'll tell you that. Okay, that's full. Let's run this up and sell it because we're in the hole. So let's run this compost up and sell it. See if we can get ourselves out of the hole. And I want to try a different route this time. This tractor is not very powerful. So generally I take this shortcut here, which is this, well, it's not a shortcut, it's just a different way of going. I usually take this cutoff right here, and I it's just my opinion, but I think that the hill on that cutoff is less steep than the one up above here, but I don't know, so I wanted to try it. I keep taking this tractor that way because I'm afraid it won't make this hill, but I actually never tried it. So let's see what it does. So far, so good. 12 miles an hour, 11, 10, 9, 8. Nope, it's going to make it. Well, cool beans. I was afraid it wouldn't make this hill, so I've never tried it. Well, now you know, as G.I. Joe says, knowing's half the battle. So they're making another, or made another, Transformers movie. I didn't think they'd ever make another one because they were getting so stupid. But evidently, they did. Or they are. Let's see what we make here. Now notice it looks like poo that we're selling. 58,000, very good. For 21,000. This trailer only holds 21,000. And we made $58,000 on compost. That's why I want to put a compost machine on every farm. Because you're talking straw. It's a waste product. If I can make 58,000 a load and a small trailer load, pretty good money. Now, that doesn't take into consideration the economy. Now see, the next time I pull the next load up here, I'll probably get about 5,000 to 6,000 less. And then it keeps going down the more you sell. So that might be a problem, but if I've got three of them going, looks like Daryl's done. If I've got three of them running, that just means I've got compost I can sell whenever I need to sell it. And again, it's waste. So even if it goes down, you're still making money on what it would be considered waste. Now you can sell straw, but I don't think the straw sells for that. Well, I'm glad to know this tractor, even though it's weak, can make that hill. Now that's a comfort right there, to know that. Tis to me anyway. All right, I'm going to run this guy up while I've got him and grab some straw so that I can refill. Oh, somebody missed part of this field. Uh-oh. Was that Daryl? Daryl, you missed part of the field, buddy. Oh, goodness. That, you see, now that's my fault. Generally, on this field, and I know it, generally on this field, I will manually go the length of the field before I hire somebody. So that was my fault. That wasn't Daryl's fault. I got to take care of my helpers because Remember earlier when I was telling you there's so much to do on the farm, I don't know what I'd do if I didn't have helpers to help me. It'd be impossible, it'd be an impossible task. All right, sunflower's ready on that one. Let's go to the next one. We'll just work our way down. Okay, I think on this field, I can actually hire somebody and they'll take over. Let's find out. Craig, got Craig in the house. Craig Dodd, he's a good worker. He'll get her done. All right, let's go sell this. I can't go inside the tractor on this one because it's got that nasty picture in it. I don't like that. I like the John Deere fine. I just, when I'm recording, I just don't like that picture they've got in there. Now again, I got 58,000 on the last load. I'm thinking that it drops about 5,000 to 6,000, which will probably double what I've got in the bank right now. I've got 53,000 in the bank. So let's just see what we get. Here goes. All right, 53,000. So that's what, 5,000? Roughly. Okay, so I don't know what it, I don't think that's consistent that way. The next time I don't know if it'll be 5,000 or 4,000. 6,000, I don't know what it decreases, but we pretty much have all we're going to sell right now. So if I sell a little bit, like I got 100 grand, because you know I was in the hole, so two little trailer loads, that's 42,000 capacity there, made me over 110,000. That's pretty good for a waste product. So if I sell a couple of trailer loads and then stop selling and wait until this thing piles up again, the price will come back up, I think. There's only one place to sell this stuff, and that's okay, though. Let's pull this guy out of the way. I don't want him getting stuck up there. All right. And get us some straw here, and we'll run back. Here we go. So what do we have in here? 1,300,000. So we got plenty of straw. Plenty of straw. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Don't hit that tractor. Now, is this guy empty now? Let's see. Straw, pig food, grass. Nope, he's not. There's some more. This should do it, because this trailer holds 150, and there's only 115 left. So let's grab this. Let's go check out, okay, this guy's ready to go. Let's take this back up to the composter. I gotta fill these, mixing stations, this one and the pig one. I've gotta finish feeding the cows. So much stuff to do. It looks like Craig's done. So we'll catch up with Craig. Oh, he's not done. That's that weird field. Let's get this guy up there and get him unloaded. Get some more compost running. I gotta find out how much these machines cost too, because I'm gonna buy two more. Maybe. We'll see. Alright, straighten up, fly right. Come on. Straighten up. There you go. Let's move on. How's he doing? Brian's almost done with this. See what I mean? If you start in that corner up there, you end up in this corner right here. If you start in this corner right here, it gets up here and then it stops. So that's the place to start. Let's just double check and see what this looks like. Make sure you got every little piece. Where's he at? Yep, looks like he got every little, well, there's a little bit right there. All right, let's go clean that up. Wait a minute. Clean this one right up here. Oh, jeez. Did you see that? I pulled the plow up right as it got to it, so it didn't get it. That was silly. All right. That got it. Yeah, see, right there, we're going to put an extension right here for that silo, and then I'm going to put a compost maker right in up over in that area by the barn right there, by that little shed, and then we can put other things on this farm. I'm thinking about adding, you know, perhaps one of the vegetable farms, that kind of thing. All right, this is the patch that we were working on right here. Because that's something we don't have on the other farm, like bees and the greenhouses. We don't have that on the main farm, so I'm thinking about putting those on the second farm here. For a little bit of income, the honeybees and that kind of thing, Daryl. Because there's nothing else here. There's no barns, no sheds. And we'll make it into kind of a different kind of a farm. We'd call this the mother-in-law farm. Mother-in-law does some gardening and she needs those greenhouses and stuff. Where on the main farm, we're just doing farming. And animals and stuff. We ain't got no time for no greenhouses and tomatoes and stuff like that. That's girly stuff. I know. Sounds sexist, doesn't it? Hey, it's not my fault it sounds sexist. I can't be responsible for what you're thinking. Now, what was that little patch right there? Where are we? Oh, okay, I know where we're at. Never mind. I'm going to run up and get this field right here, and then we'll run across and get 11. So if I can get up in here without hitting that sign. I always hit that sign and knock it down. Not my fault. Put a stupid sign right where it shouldn't be. All right, here we go. Loop-de-loo. Get this thing started and hire somebody. Who do we have working? Andy Tom from Scotland. All the way here to plow for me. Plow my fields for me. Thank you, Andy. I guess I waited a little bit long on this one, didn't I? I should have gotten to this field right away. It's already growing. Gah. Golly gee. Yeah, I need to go around. I can make an extra $1 million picking up those gold nuggets. I should do that. I had to start the game over, the farm over, and it... Because if you remember, I picked up all of those nuggets and had to start over. And so there's the nuggets again. I should probably go ahead and pick them up. Why not, huh? That's what I say. Extra $1 million to take care of the farm. All right, I'm going to go ahead and do this. End here manually, because I think they stop. If you hire somebody, they stop right about here, I think. Right about here. So I'll just do this one myself, and then when I get to the end, I'll hire somebody. Right about here. Let's see who we got. Lynn! Lynn's on the job. Let's put our truck away. Can't be leaving my equipment out like this. Just not right. I gotta get some grass going too again. Speaking of such, let's go check on this guy. And this guy should be... Now, the hayloft should be gone now. Or empty. Not gone. Gone but not forgotten. You know how that goes. Have I got a little... Did I leave a little trailer in here? No, I didn't. Oh, I already took it over there, didn't I? I got more work done than I thought I did. Okay, so this should be it for the grass. How much grass do we have, by the way? Okay, we got almost 1.3 million of the straw. Got 153 in silage. We've got 689 in grass. So... We got the resources stacking up on us pretty good. Let's go check this hayloft out. Now, the hayloft, like I said, sells for about $40,000. If I sell, or buys, I mean, if I buy it, it costs about $40,000. I'll get about a little less than half of that because it's probably got some wear and tear on it if I sell it. So, it looks like I've got everything out of it. Yes, I do. Okay, so let's go ahead and sell it. $40,000. You saw I got on one trailer load of compost, I got 58. If I need to rebuy it, it's no big deal. So let's go to the garage and let's sell that. That'll give us room for more equipment or more buildings or whatever I want to do. Let's go ahead and sell it. Yeah, we only got 19 for it. Because it's got wear and tear on it. Okay, so there you go. We're up to 128,000. We got a little bit more room here that we can do anything we want with it. Let me get under this silage silo and see what we've got. Looks like Andy's done. So we go take care of Andy. Andy from Scotland. All right, now let me put the HUD up and see what we got in here. Okay, so... 205,000 units of silage in here, so that's going to fill this trailer. It holds 150. And let's just run around. Okay, he's empty. I need to go get him filled up again. Andy didn't quite get everything here, but that's okay. I don't blame him. It's kind of a weird field. Let's just get this little end here. And then I think the other end has a little bit on it. Usually does. Let's get that. We'll run down and get this over here. Yeah. I don't know why, but it always does. This field always has a little bit of a hiccup on the bottom here. There's the two trees I want to take out. This kind of dead-looking one here and this one right in front of me. If I do that, then I'll have a pretty clear shot of getting through here. Now, I say that every time, and I always forget to do that. Maybe I'll do it as soon as I'm done here and just get it over with while I'm thinking about it. Maybe. All right, sire somebody. See what we got. Brian Wheeler. Brian. Plow, Brian, plow. Okay, he's going to have a problem here, I think. Lynn is. We'll see how she does that, how she handles that. All right, and what happened? This should be running. How come this isn't running? Well, that doesn't have very much draw in it, so that could be the problem. Let's see. Okay, so there's 30% fuel, no waste, and compost. Yeah, it did. It did what it was supposed to do. It just didn't have enough, so I'm going to take this down and get some more straw. And get it running again. So let's see. Let's take stock of where we're at here. Field wise. All right. So we got 23, 22, and 21. Well, Lynn's finishing 21. We got 26 to do as far as that goes. We need to finish plowing up here where Brian's working. Plow 12 and 14 and 15 of 18. 15's done. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to move the cedar when Lynn's done, which she stopped right there. I'll move her down and do 26, and then we'll come back up doing 17, 11, 12, 14, 15, and 18, and we'll be all ready for the next harvest. Cool beans. Let's run up here and get some of this straw. But wait a minute. But wait, there's more. Let me figure out why she stopped here. They always do. I don't know why. Always do. All right. So Lynn finished there, and Addie is picking up where Lynn left off. Good old Addie. All right. Do a good job, sir. And I know he will. The silage maker. I wish that thing dumped a little faster. But it's okay. He can work while I'm doing other stuff. It's fine. It just could be kind of nice if you such a big trailer if it didn't take so long to fill it up. So in the next episode, I think we'll finish topping the feed off for the cattle, and then we should be getting into the next harvest. All right, where is the... What? I just went right on past the straw. There it is. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and call an episode here. I hope you had fun. If you did, give it a like, share it with a friend, subscribe if you haven't. And if you'd like to learn a little bit more about supporting my channel, head over and take a look at my Patreon page. And I'll see you on the farm the next episode. Happy farming.